My name is Mahal Q. Quincy. I'm from Chiwin San Primary School. Today, I'm going to share the end of the Witch, the Lion, and the Wardrobe. The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe by Quincy Mook. One day, the White Witch went with Autumn again. The snow was falling as she went into the country yard. Before the White Witch and Autumn drive off, she called methods to kill all of the humans. Autumn fetched Turbo, but he brought Lucy, Susan, and Peter back to Narnia. After a while for driving, the witch said stop at the page that had fog. After that, the children had walked for hours. When they came to a stop, they had been just as surprised as Autumn when they saw the winter reflection. Therefore, they all knew when this magic spring again that something had gone wrong. It was then that they all received that the witch could no longer to be able to use her salvage. Suddenly, Adam, Lucy, Susan, and Peter heard a sound of music on their right. So they went to have a see, as then stuck in the center. Amongst them have many great centers. Autumn tried to look at Adam's face and caught a dimple of his golden mane, and his great rolled over Jim's eyes. None of them could really look at him. They went all trembling. Autumn called Aslan as brave as he could. Aslan said nothing, but mortally stuck looking at Autumn with his great and changing eyes. He seemed so to he understood what Autumn, and there was nothing more to be said. For the last part of the junior, it was Susan and Lucy who saw most of Aslan. He did not talk very much, seemed very sad. On that night, Lucy and Susan couldn't sleep, so they decided to go for a walk. The moonlight was bright and seemed so quiet. Then they saw Aslan walking in front of them, and he was so disappointed. So Lucy and Susan followed him. After that, Aslan stopped and looked around. So he saw Lucy and Susan and said, "Why are you following me?" Lucy answered, "We can't sleep, so we decided to have a walk, and we saw you." "Can we go with you?" said Susan. Well, Aslan didn't want they go with him, but Lucy and Susan didn't listen. They followed him sneakily. Then he turned from them and walked out on the top of the hill. Oh no, the witch was on the hill too. When the witch saw Aslan, she looked happy. She said, "Fool him, fast!" Lucy and Susan were crouching in the brief. Then the ape pulled its crotch so tight that they cut into his flesh. Then the witch wanted to kill Aslan. Susan and Lucy did not see the actual moment of the killing. After the witch left, Lucy and Susan cried out slowly, and they cried loudly. On the next day of morning, they met Mr. Thomas, and he told them that the witch could kill Aslan army and humans for those days. So you guys need to be more careful. How about you? Do you want to stay with us? It could be more safe, said Peter. Oh, thanks so much, but I need to stay with my friends. After that, they decide not to go out at night. After a few days, four children receive a letter from the witch. They all felt very scared. The letter from the witch. "Hello, kids. I want to meet you guys. Are you free on tomorrow night? I'm looking forward to see you." After the discussion, the four students decided to go back to the wardrobe tomorrow morning. Four guys of them bonded with their friends, Mr. Thomas. They had a party with each other. In the morning, that is the time the four children had to leave. The four kids packed up their things and said goodbye to their friends. In the next moment, they all came trembling out of a wardrobe door into the empty room. That is the very end of the adventure of the wardrobe, but Snorlier could never turn light again.